On today's Film Room Edition, we're going to take a look at rookie linebacker Matt Milano, someone that Bills fans are looking forward to seeing play a lot more. He only played in 449 snaps, but he did make a difference. He registered 43 tackles on the season, 19 stops, but he did manage to get his hands on two passes, one being a pass deflection and one being an interception. And that interception came against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So let's step into the film room to see the defense that the Bills played and the coverage that led to this interception by the rookie linebacker.
The Buccaneers are in the two-minute drill. There's 33 seconds left in the half, and it's 2nd and 5 from the 24-yard line. They send out a 2x2 set with 11 personnel, and their tight end Cameron Brate is in the slot. And what you're going to see to the top of the screen is just a speed out by the number one receiver. The number two receiver is just going to run a little curl just inside the slot corner. To the bottom of the screen, the number one wide receiver is just running a deep comeback route, but their primary target is Cameron Brate in the slot versus Matt Milano. So the Bills sent out their nickel defense and played quarters coverage, which means Trey White and EJ Gaines are both reading the number two receiver, which are the slot receivers here. And if that receiver goes vertically past the linebacker level, they have all of number one. So it'll turn to man-to-man coverage. The inside defenders, Matt Milano and Leonard Johnson, their job is to take some speed off the number two receiver. So if that number two receiver is going down the seam, he's just supposed to reroute him outside, take some of that speed off of that, release him, and then cover the hook, the curl, the flats, whoever shows in those areas. Preston Brown, the Mike linebacker, is hanging low and matching the running back. The two deep safeties, they're reading the number two receiver as well. Anything that goes past linebacker level vertically, they are going to pick up that receiver. So then it does become man-to-man coverage. So it's a good way for a defense to match up versus all vertical routes and to prevent big plays. But on this play, you got to give credit where credit is due. Rookie Matt Milano makes a heck of a play on Cameron Brate. So as I mentioned before, he's supposed to reroute and take some speed off of that number two route, and he actually doesn't do a good job of that. If you look at Leonard Johnson to the top of the screen, he skills this. He does a really good job of taking speed off of that and releasing to his designated area. But Matt Milano to the bottom of the screen doesn't do such a good job of doing that. Doesn't take much speed off of the route by Brate. Once Brate is even with him, Milano's eyes are on the quarterback, and this is where his instincts take over. Rather than just release him and run to the flats to the bottom of the screen here to undercut this deep comeback route, he's just going to continue into his back pedal, flip his hips, and go and get the ball. And this is just a heady play by a rookie. I mean, as soon as that tight end passed Milano, this is a nice little hole right here in between the safety and the linebacker. And of course, you're going to have this safety trying to drive on that, but if that's thrown on time, which it is by Jameis Winston, I mean, that's really a tough ball for Hoyer to make a play on. So if Milano doesn't continue to get depth here, this is probably a completed pass. It's thrown on time. As soon as Brate snaps his head around, I mean, that's going to be a completion, and they're going to have the ball right near midfield towards the end of the half. But instead, Milano just does a heck of a job of flipping those hips. I mean, that's special right there. That's why the Bills drafted him. You know, that's why they eased him into the lineup last year, because he does have this type of athleticism. And Cameron Brate is no slouch. This guy's good. Milano knew that Winston wanted to attack this coverage with that little skinny post, that little bender route versus the too high set. So it's just a heck of a play by Milano. And you're going to see from the front four, there's really not much of a rush. Lorenzo Alexander and Marcel Darius to the left-hand side of your screen are going to run a tech stunt, which means Darius is going to jam the tackle here, and you're going to have the looper Alexander shoot inside. And on the right-hand side of the screen, you're going to have Kyle Williams and Jerry Hughes executing an exit stunt, which means that Jerry Hughes is going to dive inside into the B gap. You're going to have Williams as a looper outside, but they don't really cause much pressure. It's blocked up really well. So this is all coverage. And you know what? The quarterback, Winston, actually does a really good job, too, of staying disciplined with his eyes. You see him. He's looking right down the middle of the field. He's not tipping the defense on where he wants to go with the ball. Winston holds the secondary with his eyes, hits the top of his drop, knows he wants to hit Brait. He's trusting him, not expecting that linebacker to be there. But he is, and Matt Milano registers his only interception of the 2017 season.
We saw those types of flashes from Milano in the run and pass game last season. That's why a lot of fans are excited about this upcoming season. The Bills went out and got Tremaine Edmonds, obviously another very athletic linebacker. And pairing those two together, they have a really good core for the next few years. The type of athleticism that those two possess will really open up the defensive playbook, especially in pass coverage. Overall, the Bills played a lot of vanilla coverages last year, a lot of zone defense. They played zone defense up over 70% last year, so expect them to kind of mix it up a little more and balance it out. With the upgrades along the defensive line and the linebacker core, I do believe the Bills defense will be a lot better this coming season. If you appreciate what we're doing at cover1.net, please be sure to subscribe to our premium content. You'll get content only available to premium subscribers. Make sure to download the cover1 app for iOS and Android systems. Anytime new content drops, you'll get a push notification to let you know that it's available to take a look at. And finally, if you like these videos, make sure to subscribe to our channel. We have a lot of big things coming on the horizon, and we appreciate your support. So thanks for tuning in.